वेलकम टू मास्टर कैम एकेडमी।
वेलकम टू मास्टर कैम एकेडमी। सो टुडे आवर प्रेजेंट टॉपिक SN2 रिएक्शन। सो इन इयर सेशन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड SN1 रिएक्शन। सो इन डिटेल नाउ इट इज SN2 रिएक्शन। सो व्हाट इज टू स्टैंड्स फॉर? इट इज बाई मॉलिक्यूलर एंड S स्टैंड्स फॉर सब्स्टिट्यूशन एंड N स्टैंड्स फॉर न्यूक्लियोफिलिक। ओके, सो बायोमॉलिक्यूलर न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन। व्हाट इट इज बायोमॉलिक्यूलर न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन? सो वन एग्जांपल फॉर दैट, जनरली प्राइमरी अल्काइल हैलाइड्स अंडरगो SN2 रिएक्शन। सो इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ एक्वस केओएच इट कन्वर्ट्स इनटू प्राइमरी अल्कोहल प्लस KX. So this is the general reaction for SN2 reaction example. So in this, if you take this as methyl bromide CH3Br, okay, now aqueous KOH, it is methanol CH3OH plus KBr. So what is this? Methyl bromide and this is methanol or methyl alcohol. Okay, this is example for SN2 reaction. In these reactions, rate is directly proportional to alkyl halide and as well as nucleophile. Okay, rate depends on both. So in SN1 reaction, rate depends on only alkyl halide, but here rate depends on both alkyl halide and OH minus. Then this can predict from mechanism only. Okay, so here rate is depends on both the reactants, that is alkyl halide and OH minus. This is nucleophile. So that's why it is called bimolecular. That's why it is called bimolecular, and it is a first order with respect to alkyl halide and a second order with respect to this alkyl halide and OH minus. So overall it is second order reaction. Overall SN1 reaction is a first order reaction, here it is second order reaction, and it is here as rate depends on both, that's why it is called bimolecular reaction. Now let us study this mechanism of this SN2 reaction. Okay, mechanism. This completes in only one step. Okay, so that's why it is a single step reaction. So in this, CHBr, this is methyl bromide. Now OH minus attack. Now it forms a transition state, that is represented as like this. This is called transition state. Now loss of Br minus leads to the formation of product, that is CH dotted line HOH. What is this? Methyl bromide and this one is methyl alcohol. Okay, methyl bromide conversion to methyl alcohol. So with SN2 reaction, so in this SN2 reaction only one step is there. So this is just a transition state. So how this is formed? OH minus, this is nucleophile, OH minus starts sharing its electrons to carbon of alkyl halide exactly from the backside to the carbon halogen bond. Okay, so to this backside to the CBr bond, OH minus attacks on carbon. And so due to the sharing of this electrons with carbon, so partial bond. So here one state is formed, that is hypothetical state, imaginary state, that is transition state. Okay, this carbon halogen moves away from carbon by taking its pair of electrons. That's why a partial bond is shown in this transition state. What is this transition state? Having partial bonds with OH minus and Br minus. So how it is? Because of the sharing of electrons from the backside to the CBr bond, OH minus attack, and also carbon halogen bond. Here halogen moves away from carbon by taking its shared pair of electrons. That's why a imaginary state is formed, that is called transition state. So in which OH and Br partially bonded to the carbon, and later on in the next Br minus leaves as Br, bromine atom leaves as Br minus and leads to the formation of final product. What is that? Methyl alcohol. So this is the conversion method, methyl bromide to methyl alcohol. So in this reaction, rate is directly proportional to the methyl bromide CH3Br and also OH minus, because is at the initial step, the step one only, both reactants methyl bromide and OH minus attacks takes place. So both, that's why rate depends on both methyl bromide and OH minus. So if you compare with this reaction with SN1 reaction, what happens in SN1 reaction? So from the alkyl halide, after the cleavage of carbon halogen bond, only OH minus attacks takes place. That's why it is SN1 reaction. So rate depends only on alkyl halide, not on nucleophile. So but here what happened? Rate is directly proportional to alkyl halide and OH minus ion. Why it is? At the initial step only, so bond formation takes place between C and OH, and bond cleavage slowly. So bond cleavage takes place between carbon and halogen. So that's why carbon breakage of this bond takes place, bromine minus leaves out and leads to the formation of methyl alcohol. Okay, here the energy required to break this carbon halogen bond is obtained by the energy released by the formation of COH bond. So here COH bond formation releases energy. That released energy is utilized here for the breakage of this carbon halogen bond. Okay, it's clear. So here the energy released by the formation of COH bond is utilized to this breakage of carbon halogen bond. So if you compare, you can compare this with this SN1 reaction. How can you compare this? In this SN1 reaction, what happened? So alkyl halides, so so here tertiary alkyl halide, you can take CH3 Br, SN1 reaction. So it forms CH3 plus carbocation is formed. This is step one, rate determining step. And next in the second step two, here it is formation of final product. Okay, by the attack of OH minus from the front side or from the back side, from the front side or from the back side. So that's why two possible products are formed. Okay, so in this, what happened here? Solvation means in presence of polar protic solvents, favors SN1 reaction. Okay, presence of non-polar solvents, so non-polar solvents are no solvent is required for this SN2 reaction. Here polar protic solvents, what happens here? So by the solvation process, for the cleavage of CBr bond, energy required for the cleavage of CBr bond is obtained by the solvation process. So in the solvation process, around the halide ion, so protons of protic solvents So surrounds around the halogen atom. So that is called solvation. Due to the solvation process, the energy required for this breakage of carbon halogen bond is provided by this solvation process. That's why cleavage will become easy. So here how it will become easy? Because of the formation of COH bond. It releases energy that is utilized here. So for the breakage of carbon bromine bond. So this is first it forms transition state and next methyl alcohol final product will be formed. Okay, so observe this structure. Observe the structure, methyl bromide and methyl alcohol. This is just exactly opposite to this structure. Okay, so inversion structure. That's why it is called inversion product and also called as Walden inversion product. What it is called? Walden, scientist name. So who invented this? So that is inversion product. So Walden inversion product. Okay, so this is just like inverted umbrella in a high wind. So you can imagine how inverted umbrella in a high wind. So this is just like umbrella. So it is inverted umbrella. Okay, so just inversion takes place. So that's why in place of bromine here OH group is there. So that's why this is called Walden inversion product. Okay, so who proposed this one? This product name, so by Walden, that's why it is Walden inversion product. So this is about SN2 reaction. So here important points are, it completes only one step. Okay, so energy required for the breakage of bond is obtained by formation of COH bond. That is also important. And this is transition state, is an imaginary state. It's not a discrete molecule. It cannot be isolated directly actually. So cleavage of this bond takes place and formation of that bond with the COH takes place. That is actual step. Okay, just it is an imaginary step. So this is, it cannot be isolated. Okay, so as it is not a discrete molecule, that's why it is not isolated. And the rate depends on both, that's why it is called SN2 reaction. Okay, so here the reactivity of alkane halides towards this reaction, that is reactivity order. Reactivity, that is methyl halide has great reactivity than ethyl halide. It is having great reactivity than isopropyl halide. Then it is having high reactivity than tertiary butyl halide. Okay, methyl halide. So this is methyl halide, ethyl halide, both are primary alkyl halides. So greater than secondary alkyl halide, tertiary alkyl halides. Why methyl halide has high reactivity towards this SN2 reaction? Towards SN2 reaction. So that we can explain with this steric effect. So this is methyl bromide. Okay. So now if you take this CH3Br. What is this? Tertiary butyl bromide. So here what is the step involved here? OH minus attack. From which side? Exactly opposite to carbon halogen bond. Okay, OH minus should attack from just opposite to the carbon halogen bond on this carbon. So to this attack of OH minus, it is difficult if here bulkier groups are there, bulky groups. Okay, so here methyl groups are bulkier groups compared to hydrogen. That's why due to this steric hindrance, OH minus attack on carbon from the backside is difficult compared to here. Here hydrogen atoms, okay, simpler atoms, okay. So that's why here no steric hindrance is there. Directly OH minus can attack from backside to carbon halogen bond. But here, as these are bulkier groups, OH minus attack on this carbon exactly from opposite side to the carbon halogen bond is difficult. That's why. So what is the reason? That is steric hindrance. Due to this steric hindrance, so it is very difficult to the attack of OH minus on this carbon. So that's why. So in this case, SN2 reactivity is less for this tertiary butyl halide. So as increasing the bulkiness, increasing the bulkiness of groups around the carbon atom, so SN2 reactivity decreases. So here CH3X, all are hydrogen atoms only. That's why reactivity is more. Here two hydrogens, one and one methyl. Here two methyl groups. So here three methyl groups. Okay, with increasing the bulkiness of groups around carbon atom, so reactivity decreases. What are the favorable conditions for this SN2 reactions? Favorable conditions. So in this, first, no steric hindrance. So already we have discussed this point. So with increasing bulkiness around the carbon atom, so steric hindrance increases, that's why reactivity decreases. That's why primary alkyl halides have high reactivity than secondary alkyl halides can tertiary alkyl halides. Okay, so it also depends on halogen atom. Okay, so that follows Ri, alkyl halides reactivity is greater than alkyl bromides, next alkyl chlorides, alkyl fluorides. Okay, because leaving capacity is I minus is greater than Br minus is greater than Cl minus greater than F minus. So in this, what is the first in the step? Only one step is there, that is halogen leaves as halide ion and OH formation takes place. So that's why halogen leaves as halide ion. So which can leave easily? So that's reactivity is more. That's why. So alkyl iodides are high reactivity in this reactions. Okay. Next also depends on here strength of nucleophile. Okay. So if strong nucleophiles, presence of strong nucleophiles, example alkoxide ion OR minus. Okay, so presence of this strong nucleophile alkoxides, so reactivity of SN2 reaction is more. And also fourth one, concentration of nucleophile. Okay, if the concentration is high, high nucleophile concentration, then so reactivity is high. Okay, so and also solvent. So here non-polar or less polar solvents. So these are the favorable conditions for SN2 reactions. So what are they? Steric hindrance. So if there is no steric hindrance, that's why primary alkyl halides, these are having no steric hindrance, that's why so they are high reactive. So it depends on halogen atom, so which can leave as halide ion, so that's reactivity is high. And strength, so which has in presence of strong nucleophiles and also concentrated nucleophiles, so the reactivity is high. So in presence of solvents, non-polar solvents or less polar solvents. So with respect to SN1 reaction, what is this about favorable conditions? So tertiary reverse order, tertiary alkyl halide is greater than secondary alkyl halide is greater than primary alkyl halide for SN1 reaction. Okay, so here the halogen atom is same because in both cases halogen leaves as halide ion. That's why So in both cases, the reactivity order with respect to halogen atom is same. So here, moderate nucleophile or less strong nucleophiles, that is example C2H5OH, okay, in presence of those OH minus, here OR minus, okay, strong OR minus is strong nucleophile than OH minus. So in presence of OR minus, SN2 reaction is favorable condition, and presence of OH minus, that favors SN1 reaction, and less nucleophile concentration favors SN1 reaction. And solvent, with respect to solvent, polar solvents enhance the SN1 reaction. So here non-polar or less polar solvents enhance the SN2 reaction. So this is about favorable conditions for SN2 reaction, and also comparison with SN1 reaction. Okay, now here, if starting alkyl halide is a optically active compound, then what are the products? So we have discussed this same with SN1 reaction. So SN1 reaction with optical active compound by SN1 reaction gives a racemic mixture. Racemic mixture, what is that? Retention product and inversion product. And what about this here in a SN2 reaction? So let us take one example. So which is optical active alkyl halide? So that is CBr CH3 H C6H13. Okay, this is alkyl halide. So in this, OH minus attacks takes place from the backside, and what is the directly I am writing the product, so without writing transition state, so that is CH3 H C6H13 OH, inversion product. Okay, what is this? So this is L2 bromo octane 6 7 8 carbons octane, second position bromine atom is there. So L means levo, so levo means which rotates plane polarized light towards anti-clockwise direction, that is called levo. Okay, now here it is D which rotates plane polarized light towards clockwise direction. So why it is opposite to L? Okay, L it is, now it is D. So because, so what we get? Inversion product. So as it is inversion product, so configuration is also inverted. So that means opposite configuration. So opposite to L is D. That's why opposite configuration product will be formed. So that's why two here octanol. Okay, so this is the product, that is D. Okay, this is inversion product. Inversion product is formed. Okay, so this is about SN2 reaction. So what is your conclusion in SN2 reaction? So the conclusion, SN2 reaction, optically active compound gives inversion product. Inversion product. SN1 reaction, optically active compound gives racemic mixture. So that, what it is called, the process is called racemization. So racemization is observed in SN1 reaction. So racemization is absent in SN2 reaction. What is the racemic mixture? So retention product plus inversion product, that is 50-50% retention product and inversion product, that is racemic mixture. And for SN2 reaction, only inversion product is formed, that is what it is called, Walden inversion product. So no rhizomerization takes place. That is the difference with respect to the optical activity of starting compound. Okay, so next, rearrangement also. In this SN1 reactions, rearrangement possible. Rearrangement possible. But here, no rearrangement. Here, no rearrangement. But here, rearrangement takes place. Only inversion product, no rearrangement. Here, racemic mixture and rearrangement, there is a possibility. So, this is about the SN2 reaction. Differences between SN1 reactions and SN2 reactions. Okay, so what are the differences between those two? So in this first one, we know that rate is directly proportional to alkyl halide only. But here, rate is directly proportional to alkyl halide and nucleophile. Nucleophile. So that's why it is unimolecular. This is bimolecular. Unimolecular and bimolecular. So, and this is a first order kinetics. First order kinetics. And this one is second order kinetics. Okay. First order with respect to Rx and first order with respect to a nucleophile. Overall, it is a second order kinetics. Next, third one. Here, carbocation. Carbocation or carbonium ion, this is intermediate. Intermediate. What is intermediate? Carbocation. Next, in this, a imaginary state is formed, that is called transition state, in which OH and bromine attached to carbon, they partial bonds. So that's why it is transition state. And next, fourth one, here order of reactivity, benzyl halide is greater than allyl halide, is greater than tertiary alkyl, is greater than primary secondary alkyl, is greater than primary alkyl, is greater than methyl. Okay, methyl halide. So this is the reactivity order of different alkyl halides. So in this, reactivity order is methyl halide is greater than ethyl halide, is greater than, so secondary alkyl halide is greater than tertiary alkyl halide. Okay, what is the reason? Due to the steric hindrance. Here no steric hindrance, that's why favors SN2 reaction. So in the next, fifth one, here backside and front side attack of nucleophile on carbonium ion, on carbocation. Backside or front side attack of nucleophile on carbocation. So that's why if it is a optical active compound, two products will be formed. One is retention product, one is inversion product. So that's why here in the fifth point, here only backside attack of nucleophile on alkyl halide, on alkyl halide. So this is sixth point. Due to this, racemization takes place. So because of these two possibilities, and here the sixth point, here no racemization. Okay, so only inversion product, what it is called, Walden inversion product only formed. Okay, so this is, and next, with respect to the seventh one, with respect to the nucleophiles. Okay, so writing from here, starting. So next to seventh one, that is nucleophile. Presence of mild nucleophiles favors SN1 reactions. And the seventh point, and next is strong nucleophiles. Strong nucleophiles favors SN2 reaction. Example, alkoxide ions, OR-. So here example, C2H5OH, okay, OH-. Okay, next, eighth, in presence of here less concentration of nucleophiles favors SN1 reaction. Here high concentration of nucleophiles favors SN2 reaction. And next, here ninth point, here polar solvents favors SN1 reaction. Here non-polar or less polar solvents favors SN2 reaction. Okay, so this is about differences between SN1 reactions and SN2 reaction. So with respect to the mechanism, here what happens? So CH3, BR, tertiary alkyl halides generally undergoes SN1 reaction. Here primary alkyl halides undergoes SN2 reaction. What is the reason? Just because of steric hindrance. Here no steric hindrance. Here steric hindrance is there. As it is having no steric hindrance, so here backside attack of OH- takes place, leads to the formation of inversion product. Okay, but here it completes in only one step. But here it completes in two steps. First, formation of carbocation takes place. From here OH- attacks or nucleophilic attack takes place from the front side and from back side. So that's why it leads to the formation of two products if it is optically active compound. It leads to the formation of CH3, OH, inversion product, and CH3, OH. Okay, so it is inversion retention products. So that is racemization. So this happens if it is optically active compound. Okay, so that means here it is R1, R2. Okay, all three are different. So then it leads to the formation of inversion product and a retention product. That is in case of SN1 reaction. So SN1 reaction, racemization takes place and formation of retention and inversion products with 50-50 ratio. But here only inversion product is formed, Walden inversion product that is called. So that is the difference between SN1 and SN2 reactions.